My name is Peter Ram. I'm a professor at TU Delft. So I'm not just working on the process, but also on the raw materials. And our lab basically tries to produce new innovations in recycling that are able to make really valuable materials out of waste. Plastic packaging is a very special topic. Packaging is about 40% of all the plastics that we use in the world. So next to, for example, plastics as a building material or as a material in cars or in electronics. So 40% is a lot. And also because packaging has a very short lifetime, it is ideal for recycling. The moment that it's produced, it's used, and it is available for recycling. That's different for other products, for example, like cars. There the plastics is hidden in the product for 15 years. And by the time that it becomes available again, it's really very old. Well, as you know, all the world uses plastics. But specifically in Europe, we recycle plastics. And the reason is that we are quite a wealthy region. So the people that live here have a lot of money. And they don't like waste. So what they do is they pay something extra to make it possible that we recycle the plastics. And in itself, that's also already very special, because if you look at other materials, most of the other materials that are produced in bulk, they are perfectly recyclable. And that is because they have value. If you look at steel, glass, paper, everything that that is produced by those material companies, after its lifetime, it has enough value and it can be recyclable in such a good way that you can produce a material that can be used to replace virgin. But for plastics, that is different. When plastics is used and it becomes obsolete, it gets a quality that is very difficult to bring back to the virgin level. So if, for example, you have a shampoo bottle, you use it, it gets to a recycler, then it's very difficult to make that plastic into another shampoo bottle. Because in plastics there are a lot of additives that once you try to recycle them, make the plastics worse. For example, if you start with a plastic that is white or transparent and you try to recycle it, you will very often see that the plastic suddenly becomes yellow. That is an additive that was put into the plastics in principle to avoid that the plastics during its lifetime will be oxidized. So it's an antioxidant. But there are many different types of antioxidants. And some of these types produce a discoloration. They make a yellow color. Others don't. But what we see is that in plastic packaging, we almost always see the additives that produce a yellow color.